Hello everyone, morning. First of all, warm welcome to Oracle Fusion HCM training offered by InnoGeeks. In this video, we'll see how to create an OTBI summary report. In the previous video, we've seen how to create a detailed report using OTBI, which stands for Oracle Transactional Business Intelligence. And in this video, we'll see how to create a summary report. And the use case is to print employee headcount, or build an OTBI summary report to print employee headcount by gender. And we want to display the output not as a table, but as a vertical bar chart, okay? And yes, usually the summary reports will display output in a graphical format, such as a bar or a line chart or a pie chart. And it is these summary reports that will be eventually used to build OTBI dashboards, which we'll see in the next video. And the use case is to build OTBI summary report to print employee headcount by gender as a vertical bar chart. Okay, let's get started. I've logged into the Oracle ERP cloud instance. And let me go to the home page and show you the navigation from there. From Oracle Cloud homepage, go to Tools, and under Tools, you don't see, you go to My Reporting, and you click on Build a Report. Click on Browse Catalog. Go to shared folders, and under shared folders, there will be a folder called custom. You have to place your custom reports in the custom folder. And we have created InnoGeeks folder in here in the previous video. And we have created OTBA folder inside that, and we have placed our OTBA detailed report in here. So we have created this worker assignment, a detailed report, which will print a worker and their assignment details based on a department. Let's create a summary report now. Okay, so click on the plus icon, select analysis, and we'll select the same subject area that we picked up for a detailed report. We need to get the worker headcount based on gender. So to do that, I have to select a workforce management, a worker assignment real-time subject area. I'll pick it up. And I need to select the columns that I need. I need to get the gender, add the gender of worker. So expand worker. You will see as a person gender, add it to the selected columns list, and you have a headcount column as well that's available under worker assignment details, I believe, under worker assignment. Expand worker assignment and you will see a headcount. Add the headcount to the selected columns list. And let's save the report. Worker headcount by gender. OTBA analysis. And if you go to results tab, you should see the employee gender and the headcount. And you could see that you could see four genders in there, male, female, and you have not specified, and you have non-binary. And for some of the genders, or for some of the persons or employees, remember, when you're hiring an employee, gender is not a mandatory field. So it could have been left blank as well when an employee is hired. So there are 79 such persons. So if you're building a report like this, wherein you just have two columns and it's basically a summary report. In reports like this, it makes sense to display it in a graphical format rather than as a table, right? So whenever you build an OTBI report, by default, if you come to results tab, you will see the output displayed as a table. If you want to add other visualization options or delete it, or change the table to other one, you can do that as well. So if you want to add new visualization options, you can click on this. Can click on the new visualization options, new view, and you've got quite a few options available here. You can spend whole day explaining or exploring all these options that are available. And my intention is to display this information as a vertical bar chart. So I'll go to graph, bar chart, and as a vertical bar chart. Select that. And you see that that option got added as a new visualization option now. And I no longer want to have a tabular output, I'll take it off. So you could see headcount and you could see the person gender and you could see the headcount displayed now. And if you notice, yes, the headcount is getting displayed as a number, but doesn't it make sense to display it as a percentage rather than a number? So if I'm looking at this report and if I want to know what percentage of my employees are female, I'll have to open up the calculator and do the math myself, right? So I'll have to do a calculation like 1150 divided by total number of employees that I have, right? So instead of that, let's try to make the life of end user easy. Let's convert these numbers into percentages. And how do we do it? We don't have any percentage column available in the subject area, but you can add new calculated measures. You can add new calculated measures directly from the results tab. Click on new calculated measure. You can give it a name. You can select to what folder you want to save and what should be the column name. So I want to save it to the same worker assignment folder from where we picked up the headcount. And I want to call it as a percentage of workers. And I want to write in a formula here. And the formula should be like this. It will be a headcount. So first of all, open and close the brace, close the braces, add the headcount. That is headcount divided by a summary, right? So we need to take, so the headcount will give you what is the headcount of that particular gender divided by the sum of total headcount, right? So include all the employees of all the genders. So to do that, I will use aggregate function. Sum. And in the expression, I will add in the headcount. So it is a headcount by summary of headcount. Okay, into 100. So let me just check if I've got that correct. Or I can probably just copy paste this. So it is a headcount by a sum of headcount into 100. I can just copy this and paste it here. Click OK. So all we have done is added in a new measure called percentage of workers, which is a calculated measure. And you see the percentages now, you see the headcount, and you also see the percentages displayed there. So you see that 41% of my employees are male, 41.8 to be precise. And I want to take out this headcount and display only the percentage of workers. Okay, so I can edit the graph. And from the measures that I'm displaying in the graph, I can take out the headcount. Okay, so from the measures, I will take out, reduce the zone size a little bit. I can take out the headcount from there and I'll just leave a percentage of workers there. Okay, and what do you see now? You see the graph displaying the percentage of workers. So you see that 55% of my employees are male, 41% or 42% female, and a very less percentage of the workers does not have a gender assigned. And you've got enough options available when it comes to changing the display properties of the graph. Okay, so you can change it by default. Default options are selected. You can also change it to 3D if you want. And it appears like this. And you can also change it from default to maybe cylindrical to see the output in a much better form. So you have a lot of options. You can play around with them. And this is how you build an OTBI summary report. And in the next video, we will see how to plug in this, how to create an OTBI dashboard by plugging in the OTBI detail and the summary reports that we have created previously. Okay. Thank you very much for watching this video, guys. In case you are interested in Oracle Fusion HCM training offered by YouNoGeeks, call us or WhatsApp us on this number 7396033555, or you can email us on info@YouNoGeeks.com. Thank you.